Preboat Ferrer a long time has had a great sailboat out there in the Sanibel. Now we have a new Preboat sailboat out there in the Endeavor. Today we're here with Derek Wagner from Preboat. Thanks for stopping by, Derek.
Appreciate it, Gary. Glad to be here.
What can you tell us about this new Endeavor sailboat from Preboat Models?
Well, the Endeavor sailboat comes completely ready to run with battery and charger. Has a fiberglass composite hull, handcrafted. Backup motor, which is unique to our Preboat Models, Preboat sailboats, in that in case of sudden wind decrease, the boat actually has an electric backup motor, so you can get back to shore safely.
Which it is pretty cool. I mean, I know that's one of the things people starting out are kind of concerned about, of, you know, how do I launch it? How do I bring it back? What happens if the wind dies? Things like that. Now, as I mentioned, this is now the second Preboat sailboat following the Sanibel.
Correct.
Does this replace the Sanibel?
It does not replace the Sanibel. The Sanibel is a larger sailboat, Gary, and it is designed or engineered around a more intermediate to advanced sailboat enthusiast.
It's also a bit of a bigger boat, too, isn't it?
It is a larger boat. It stands about 3.5-4 feet tall.
Okay. And we've got, what would you estimate the height here on this one?
I would say this is about 24 to 28 inches tall.
Okay. And about 14, 18 inches long?
14 inches long, yep.
Okay. Now, one of the unique things, like you mentioned, is the fact that this does have an auxiliary motor system.
Correct.
Designed into it. Was that really the focal point on the design on this boat? Or what can you tell me about the motor system that's in this boat?
Well, it was one of the main focal points on this boat, being that this boat was engineered for beginners, and a lot of beginners are maybe a little timid with regards to RC sailboats in regards to getting it on the water and not being able to retrieve it in case of sudden wind loss. So what we designed was a simple, easy to use backup motor that's engaged easily with a transmitter to allow you to easily return that boat to shore or just move along until the actual wind.
Now, one of the things, too, that I noticed, I put this boat together myself, and this is really the first sailboat that I've ever worked on. I mean, we've had our pro boat or our boating buying guide that we have up on the website, but that was a boat that was already assembled. I didn't have to mess with the Sanibel at all. I was actually really impressed with how easy it, I think it took me about 10 minutes to get everything, all the lines and everything rigged. And one of the things I really appreciate is the fact, and we'll get you guys a close-up here, is these lines actually look like they're all marked to really indicate where everything's got to go. I mean, I was really concerned about, you know, what goes where and how do I rig it up.
Yeah, that's a great point, Gary. Really, the boat comes fully assembled except for the sails, which are all, the sail lines are all rolled up to the top, and they're all labeled with a letter, with a corresponding letter on the hull. So you can simply unroll the sails, mash it up to the hull, the corresponding letter on the hull, and you are ready to go. And you should be in the water in less than an hour.
Now, a little tip too, if you do have where you find out that some of the lettering and whatnot has come off of the rigging, I know you can go to electronic stores and you can get, they're like cable labels and whatnot, where you can actually go ahead and replace where it's just alphabetically labeled A, B, C, and D. So if you do happen to have one where it blows off or comes off in the water or something like that, that's easily replaceable
as
well. Along with how quick it is to get up and running due to the quick assembly time, it's also quick to get up and running because it's a complete ready-to-run, like you know, pretty much all the Preboat models.
Correct.
Does this include the battery pack and a battery charger, too, or what does someone need to get up and running with the Endeavor?
Great question. All you need to get up and running with the Endeavor is 8 AA batteries for the transmitter. A Preboat battery pack and a Preboat wall charger is included. So it is a completely ready-to-run package. Just add the batteries to the transmitter and you're ready to go.
Now, back to the motor for a minute, too. It's kind of a unique setup in the Endeavor where it doesn't use a speed controller. It actually goes back to some of the really, you know, basic or old-school RC technology in that it's just a micro switch, an on-off. It'll start the power current flow to the motor, and then it disconnects it. Really, what was the idea behind using a micro switch versus a traditional speed controller?
We wanted to make it as simple on the user as possible with as little electronics and mechanical devices inside this unit to make it easy to replace anything and less likely for anything to go wrong. To engage the electric motor, you simply bring the throttle trim all the way to the bottom, bring your throttle stick, the left stick, all the way to the bottom. The sail arm will reach the micro switch at that point, engage the electric motor. And when you're finished running the electric motor, simply bring your throttle trim up to the midpoint, which will disengage the electric motor and you're back to sailing.
Now, another tip here, too, to be real careful of, and I actually did this when I was setting up the rigging lines, make sure that you've got some play in the lines here. If you have them too taut, that servo arm actually can't come back and engage the micro switch.
That's correct. That's
so,
correct.
So you really want to keep an eye on that as you're going ahead and getting it basically ready to go. Above and beyond that, you mentioned that it does come with a ProBoat battery pack.
Yep.
You know, I'm assuming since it's really just driving the servos, you're going to get, you know, 25, 30 minutes worth of runtime easily out of it?
You get 25, 30 minutes easily, more depending on how often you engage the electric motor. But to that point, the electric motor is not meant to be an all-out, use the electric motor constantly. It's really meant to be a temporary fix to an issue where if the wind decreases or you're in a tough spot where you can't get out of.
Well, that's a good point, too, because unlike other ProBoat boats, there's no motor cooling system or anything like that in here. It's all encapsulated, so you can really overheat and damage that motor if you're running it constantly. What about launching this? I mean, it's one of the things that I've always kind of struggled with is the fact that you've got this long keel on the bottom here that you've got to get a couple feet out in the water before you can hand launch it, right?
Great point. With the long keel, you need to launch it from a dock or a very deep shoreline or a very steep shoreline or off of a boat.
Okay. So can we go run it?
Let's do it.
All right. We'll be back soon with a full-blown review of the ProBoat Endeavor. I want to thank Derek for stopping by. Thanks for watching. If you guys do have any comments or questions on anything that you've seen here today, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching. Let's go.